Do we seek to help others to be drawn closer to our Lord? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God. Every day, amen.
Saint Joan was born in 1666 in Anjou, France. She was employed from a young age at their family business, a small store next to a place of worship. She took over the store after her parents passed away. She soon had a reputation for being greedy and insensitive towards the poor, who frequently approached her for help. When Saint Joan met Francois Fouché, a poor widowed pilgrim from Rennes, on Pentecost 1693, she was told she would one day dedicate her life to helping the underprivileged. She was a little skeptical when she heard this, but as time passed, her attention became more and more consumed with tending to the less fortunate. She began providing for the underprivileged kids in her neighborhood. Then the ill, old, and impoverished came to her. She eventually shut down the family business and committed herself entirely to penance and good deeds. She then discovered the organization that would later be called the Congregation of Saint Anne of Providence. She adopted the holy name Joan of the Cross at that point. She had started 12 schools, hospices, and religious homes by the time of her death in 1736. In 1982, she was canonized by Pope John Paul II. Street people live in the downtown districts of most major cities. Well-dressed people tend to avoid eye contact, presumably out of concern that they would be approached for alms. Saint Joan felt that way up until the day one of them touched her. The elderly woman started Joan down the path to sainthood, even though most others thought she was insane. What may possibly befall us from the next beggar we encounter? Then children were brought to him that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples rebuked them, but Jesus said, "Let the children come to me, and do not prevent them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as this." After he placed his hands on them, he went away. Schwager gives us a commentary and reflection on this passage. The parents who brought their children to Jesus wanted him to bless and lay his hands upon them. Jesus rebuked his disciples for hindering the children from coming. But the innocence of children visibly touched him, and he touched them back with great love. What do we learn from this encounter? Children are precious in the eyes of God. Their pure hearts are worth protecting from the moment they were conceived and for the rest of their lives. That is why Christ emphatically said in the Gospel of Saint Mark, "Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea." In this encounter, Jesus showed that God's love has ample room for everyone, including the little ones. We recall with joy and gratitude how the Lord inspired CFC to be engaged in Cornerstone, a reading tutorial program for grades 2 and 3 students in public elementary schools. In South B, we started with 2 schools and later reached out to 10 other elementary schools, enabling the children to read, open new horizons for learning, creativity, and character development. Through Angkop scholarships, some even pursued and completed their tertiary education with distinctions. It was indeed a moment of grace for our community to serve as vessels for God's love, compassion, and kindness to His precious little children. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May we always seek to help others, especially our little ones, to draw closer to You. Give them the grace to grow in faith and character. As we grow in age, may we retain the childlike simplicity and humility, so that we will always remain in Your abiding presence. Jesus, King of Mercy, we trust in You. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and couples for Christ.